Here are the top 14 daily habits that may be causing your aches and how to correct them for good. 1. You have a long commute. Hunching over a steering wheel can tighten chest muscles and cause your shoulders to round. Slumping posture can zap energy and make you look heavier, not to mention cause back and neck problems. Be sure you sit at a 90-degree angle, close to the wheel so you don't have to stretch. 2. You're a desk jockey. Did you know that sitting puts 40% more pressure on your spine than standing? Regular stretching breaks may not seem like a wise way to spend your time. But skipping these habits may cause your back to suffer. That's because back muscles will weaken if you don't use them, inactive joints lose lubrication and age more quickly. Sitting at a 135-degree angle can reduce compression of the discs in the spine, so lean back slightly every now and then. Make sure your office chair supports the curve of your spine. 3. You don't veg out. Chronic or acute stress can directly trigger back pain. Sometimes even just realizing that stress may be at the root of your pain can help. You can prioritize ways to calm down each day, be it through exercise, laughing with a friend or partner, reading a good book, etc. Some helpful therapies are listening to music, climbing stairs, getting out of bed, and even sleeping. 4. You skip the gym. Get moving to alleviate aches and pains and fix back pain faster. Research shows that 40% of people become less active after back pain strikes. In fact, most sufferers would benefit from more exercise, particularly frequent walks, stretching your hamstrings and hips, which ease stiffness. 5. Your mattress is really old. A study at Oklahoma State University found that most people who switched to new bedding after 5 years slept significantly better and had less back pain. When you do replace your mattress, take a Goldilocks approach. Pick one that's not too squishy or too hard. Very firm mattresses can increase pressure on the spine and worsen pain. To help ease nighttime discomfort even more, tuck a pillow under your knees. 6. You don't do yoga. By improving circulation and lowering stress, just about any kind of exercise promotes back pain recovery. But yoga may be best. University of Washington researchers say yoga eases lower back pain faster than conventional exercises. Because it promotes deep breathing and relaxation, as well as stretching and strength, yoga may help with both emotional and structural triggers of back pain. 7. You're a crunch addict. Sit-ups and crunches may actually cause more back pain than they prevent. We hear all the time how a strong core protects your back, which is true. But crunches don't work the ab muscles that stabilize your back. In fact, they can contribute to more pain. You should do them slowly and use proper form. Include them as part of a broader core workout that also strengthens your transverse abdominis. This muscle is particularly important for a strong, steady core that supports your back. 8. You're not the best eater. Research shows that eating habits that are good for your heart, weight, and blood sugar are also good for your back. Healthy circulation brings nutrients to the spine and removes waste. If this doesn't happen, inflammation can result, and inflammatory chemicals in the back can trigger nerves to send pain signals to the brain. Healthy diet is one that reduces inflammation. Avoid excess caffeine in processed foods or partially hydrogenated oils, enriched wheat flour. You should focus on eating more whole grains, soy, nuts and seeds, protein, vegetables, and fruit. 9. Your entire life is in your purse. When you carry a heavy bag, your shoulders become imbalanced. Your body elevates the shoulder carrying the bag, which throws your spine off kilter. Doing this every day can cause back muscles to ache over time. First, carry the lightest bag possible. The American Chiropractic Association recommends that your bag, when fully loaded, weigh no more than 10% of your body weight. 10. Your bike isn't quite right. Do you routinely get a sore back after even a leisurely bike ride? You may need to adjust your equipment. Anywhere from 30 to 70% of bike riders experience some form of back pain. Try this quick test. When you straddle a road bike or hybrid, the bar should be about 1 to 2 inches from your crotch. As for your seat height, your down leg should be fully extended when the heel of that foot is on the pedal in the 6 o'clock position. Now put the ball of that foot on the pedal, there should be a slight bend in your knee in the down position. You should be able to keep a slight bend in your elbows and not feel stretched out when holding the handlebars. 11. You love high heels or flip-flops. Both lead to foot instability, which can in turn affect your back. High heels force you to arch your back, making your spinal muscles work harder. You don't have to forego trendy footwear. Just don't walk long distances in them. Commute in comfy flats or supportive sneakers, and consider adding cushioning inserts to uncomfy shoes. 12. You ignore the pain. Trying to block out pain could make it worse. Accepting pain may be the best way to mentally cope. Try thinking about the sensory details of the experience, not the negative emotions. If you have a back spasm, describe the pain to yourself, if it's burning or throbbing, and remind yourself that it will pass. 13. You watch too much TV. Parking yourself in front of the TV screens for hours and hours a day doesn't make your back very happy. Limit TV to shows you really want to watch, instead of idly channel surfing. Do some stretches or strength moves during the breaks, which will prevent muscle strain from sitting still too long. 14. You hold a grudge. To err is human. To forgive could make your aching back feel simply divine. When researchers at Duke University Medical Center studied 58 women and men with chronic lower back pain, they found that those who practiced forgiveness experienced less anger, resentment, depression, and aches. Our emotions, muscle tension, and thoughts can directly influence the strength of our pain signals, says researcher James W. Carson. If you suffer from lower back pain or back pain in general and want to learn how to get rid of it, then listen, let me tell you a quick story about one of my friends. Her name is Joyce. Joyce was in her 40s, but the arthritis in her back was so severe, she could hardly even walk. Just 10 minutes on her feet was torture. The worst part was, she had two young children that she was in such pain, it was difficult to play with them, or look after them properly. She felt like she was missing out on their entire childhood. Joyce saw physical therapists, massage therapists, chiropractors, and eventually she found herself in doctor's offices. The doctors all had the same answer for Joyce: surgery. The reason the doctors were suggesting surgery was because of her herniated disc. It was starting to slide, and if this continued, there was a high chance the disc would cut through her spinal cord, leaving her permanently paralyzed from the waist down. Joyce was devastated. She knew exactly how invasive the surgery was and wanted to avoid it at all costs. Now, listen. Your back probably isn't as bad as Joyce's was. But over time, things are only going to get worse. Your disc may soon begin to slide towards your spinal nerve also. So don't be surprised if one day, you bend down to pick something up, hear a crunch, and all of a sudden you can't breathe because the pain is so bad. That's how sudden these things can happen, so don't be surprised if this happens to you. However, Joyce's story shows that no matter how bad your situation is, there is always hope. I'm happy to say Joyce's story has a happy ending. Joyce learned the targeted spinal release method and she began using it daily. Within 3 weeks, she could easily walk for 30 minutes with zero pain. And just a few weeks after that, Joyce was completely pain-free. It was a remarkable transformation. Going from the verge of needing surgery and facing the prospect of being paralyzed from the waist down, to being pain-free in just a few weeks. All without steroid injections, endless chiropractic sessions, expensive doctor bills, and most importantly of all, this is the power of targeted spinal release method. If you are interested in learning more about this method, simply click on the link below under this video in the description and check out the method that made Joyce back pain-free in 30 days. If you're ready to take back control and get pain-free for the first time in months or even years, then you know what to do. Click the link below and start your back pain-free life now.